Thanks so much for joining us.
Good to be with you, Wolf.
As you know, President Trump says he's weighing various options in response to the attack on the Saudi oil facilities. Do you believe he has all the information he needs right now to move forward with a specific response?
Well, first of all, the answer to that is I'm not sure, because we have asked for briefings, an all members briefing or Senate Foreign Relations Committee staff briefing, and we have not received it and doesn't seem like we're going to receive it this week, number one. Number two is I think the president has to avail himself of all of the information and ascertain with specificity exactly how the attack took place, where it took place from, who generated it. And number three, if the president is now deciding to act on behalf of Saudi Arabia, an act of war may have taken place against the sovereign state of Saudi Arabia, but it didn't take place against the United States. If we are now going to be Saudi Arabia's military, well, then the president has to come to Congress, inform us of all of the intelligence, what happened. He has to make the case as to why it's in our national interest and security to ultimately have a military action, and he has to get the approval of Congress. Otherwise, we are in the midst of acting on behalf of Saudi Arabia instead of being able to act with the authority of Congress.
What's your understanding, Senator, of Iran's involvement in this attack?
Well, I mean, there are a series of reports that suggest that Iran was involved in the attack, but I don't have any specific information because we haven't had any briefings. At the end of the day, this is critical for us to know. It seems to me that if the published reports are that, in fact, Iran was either at the center of creating the attack or even may have been launched from its territory, that this is a moment to galvanize the world, to bring the information, to show the proof at the UN Security Council, to get a Security Council resolution, to ultimately take our allies who have not been happy with us because of walking away from the JCPOA and galvanizing them in action against Iran. But doing it alone in a Rambo style, without the authority of Congress and on behalf of Saudi Arabia, who is the sovereign entity that was hit, not the United States, I think would be a huge mistake.
As you know, the U.S. was hit, and the U.S. says, by Iran back in June. Do you agree with Republican Senator Lindsey Graham, who said that President Trump signaled weakness back in June when he called off at the last minute some sort of counterstrike against Iran when that U.S. drone was shot down?
Listen, in this respect, I agree more with President Trump than my dear friend and colleague, Senator Graham. There was a considered determination not to make a counterstrike that actually may have created the loss of Iranian lives, which could have exacerbated the circumstances. My understanding from reports is that there was a cyber attack against Iran to disable some of their critical infrastructure and give them a message, we can do this to you. And there have been heightened sanctions as a result of it. So at the end of the day, I think that was a calibrated response. But, you know, if we are going to be the region's police men, if we're going to be the military for Saudi Arabia and other countries in the region, we have no NATO type of relationship with them. We have no bilateral security agreement with them. This needs to come to Congress to make the case. And if you're thinking about even a limited attack upon some Iranian interests, at the end of the day, you have to think about what's the next response. Iran's proxies throughout the region give them significant reach, including to our military position throughout the region and our interest position throughout the region. So this isn't necessarily a simple one-off that you do without the potential of greater consequences. And what we don't need is to bumble into a war.
Yeah, remember, he called off that strike, he said, because he was told at the last minute the U.S. strike may kill 150 or so Iranians, and he didn't think that was a good idea. The president today announced new sanctions on Iran, Senator. Are you worried, though, that sanctions might be losing their impact as Iran is struggling under the administration's maximum pressure campaign that supposedly already exists?
Well, the most significant sanctions we can levy and have levied is against their oil sector, because that's the bulk of their economy. They're a producing nation. So at the end of the day, maximum pressure is for the effort to bring Iran to the negotiating table. So we should have maximum effort on diplomacy. This is a time to get our European partners who are part of the JCPOA to say, look how Iran is acting. Let's pressure them to come back to the table. This is a time to achieve maximum pressure in the world community to get Iran to come back to the table and to negotiate. This is a time for maximum diplomacy, it seems to me. If all you have is a pressure cooker, that doesn't have any release valve, then it's going to explode. And so it seems to me that the administration should have been and should be in the midst of a maximum campaign to get Iran back to the negotiating table.
Senator Menendez, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
The breaking news.